Hello and welcome back to my channel, The House of Secure Network. Today we're going to discuss about what is the driving force for most of the organizations to adopt a digital transformation, what is cloud computing, what are the various types of cloud that you can opt for, the various types of cloud service models, and finally, I'll be introducing cloud security. So let's get started right after this short intro. As every change is inevitable, organizations will have to adapt to change in order to grow. Let's find out the biggest driving forces for companies to adopt to cloud technology. Alright, on top of the list we have infrastructure. Every organization spends thousands of dollars on infrastructure every year, which leads to a huge amount of added expenses like maintenance, to keep up with a healthy infrastructure, the ever-increasing storage to store their data, at last leaving them with minimum options to scale up when a need arises. In the end, all of this adds up to organizations being frustrated with huge amount of capital expenditure. In other words, minimizing the capital expenditure is the biggest driving force. Let's talk about the basics first. It is an on-demand service where you get to order resources as and when you want. A single data center can be shared with multiple customers around the globe. Here's a real-life example. Imagine you're using a bus service where you buy a ticket and get off the bus when you arrive at the destination. Considering this scenario, the cloud is the bus where you just buy a ticket, use a service and get off when you're done, no questions asked. So this is how it works. You have a cloud where you as a customer would like to hire few servers, some storage, maybe some mobile services or applications, or database service to run your queries. Well, you can take all of them or just one. The choice is yours. The fun part is, you only pay for what you use. There are mainly three types of clouds that most of the cloud providers offer: a private cloud, which is only and only owned by you, a public cloud, which is available for a larger audience, and an hybrid cloud, where you can have an option to keep certain resources on premises and some of them on the cloud. When these are teamed up with all the resources that you order, it looks something like this. Well, each of these cloud types are further classified as infrastructure as a service, where you get an option to hire just the infrastructure to place your resources, platform as a service, where you get an option to hire just the platform on which you can develop certain stuff, at last, software as a service, where you get to hire the actual softwares that you can use in your organization. Software as a service is something that you use, like Salesforce to run your CRM service or Office 365 to use it as your email service. Platform as a service is something where you build with, like Amazon Elastic Beanstalk to build your applications or use Google App Engine to build your applications. Finally, infrastructure as a service, where you can place your resources like Amazon Web Services or Microsoft Azure. Well, I will drop some of the useful links for each of the services in the description below for your reference in case if you need them. As a security architect, I somehow refer security as a constant battle which is to be planned well, just like this Chinese philosopher who is well known for his military strategies. Well, it's just my way of thinking about security. Security is job zero, a famous quote used by Amazon, where security is even more important than your number one task, and I just can't agree more. I was talking about the planning before the battle. Here's the planning. Always protect your data, be it on the cloud or on premises, cause data is the new oil. It's the most crucial asset an organization should protect. Detect every threat even before it causes damage to your infrastructure. I cannot emphasize on how important access management is. Please provide limited access to your employees. But hey, all of the employees need access to web meetings these days. How do I choose which is the most secure web meeting tool? Well, just click on the link above and get to know the most secure web meeting tools. Moving on with the last element, compliance and data privacy. Always be ready for an audit and avoid being non-compliant. Next is a deep dive session where I will take you through the nitty-gritty of data protection. Until then, subscribe to House of Secure Network and hit that bell icon to get notified. Keep learning. Goodbye.